I just finished a clinical trial where those side effects were absolutely brutal, and I wasn't ready to stop trying treatment, but I got a slight window into why or how some that could happen to somebody, and how sometimes you have to balance the quality of life with the treatment. And if you have no quality of life and you're in bed every day and you're throwing up every day just to stay alive, I'm not saying it's the right or wrong decision, but I can understand now how somebody might say no to treatment and just need to be comfortable. I think that is very humane, and dying with dignity, I think, has a lot to do with that, that you're allowed to not do treatment. I think the other part of it is sometimes it's not my decision. Sometimes I want to put my head down and keep going, and my body is saying, you can't. Like, your liver's going to give out if we give you one more dose of chemo, or your lungs can't handle it. So sometimes it's not even my decision, regardless of how I think that I can move forward. The toxicity of some of these treatments is so, so high. So sometimes with risk and benefit of medicine, it's not beneficial that one more chemo treatment might kill you. It really can be that simple. So I understand it. I have no way of making a decision now when I feel okay. Obviously lots of side effects, but I have no way of knowing how I will feel when the time comes where I have to make a decision.